Hello everyone, Lunter Frankston in my Pokemon form, and today I'm doing part 6 of my reaction to Scream, the inside story. So if you guys missed part 5, go watch that before you watch this one, but this will be part 6. So I hope you guys like it, you did get this video, pick thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, turn post notifications, and let's get started.
The filmmakers received was not as inviting as the location's rolling green hills. Although the high school's administration had initially welcomed the cast and crew, it was the Santa Rosa City School Board that had the final say, and they were less than enthused.
The principal and everybody else there was extremely excited about it, so that was totally a positive experience. So we went weeks and weeks into pre-production, and then very close to the time we were going to shoot, the school board said, oh, wait a minute, you guys should let us read the script.
When we had our first presentation, we were told that it was a spoof for comedy, and what we read was not.
They read the script, and were completely affronted by it, just thought it was despicable, and should not be allowed in their high school, and pulled the contract.
The board had an opinion at the time that they didn't really want to glorify violence against children. And you have to remember, that was a sensitive period of time for Sonoma County.
Coincided with the tragedy of Polly Klass, a case that gained national attention. On October 1st, 1993, 12-year-old Polly was kidnapped at knife point from her mother's home during a slumber party. She was later found murdered, having been strangled by her abductor, Richard Allen Davis.
And the trial was just starting against Davis, who was the murderer. This was had a great impact upon the feeling.
Again, I wasn't born in the 1990s, so I had no idea this was going on.
Big town hall, and everyone was allowed to say their piece. And so one citizen after the other would come up and give their opinion as to whether or not we should shoot there.
It was a vocal crowd that greeted school district directors tonight, along with not one, but two long lines of people ready to comment on the controversy.
The entire scientific community has reached a consensus that violent viewing is harmful for people. It's harmful for most harmful for young people. It's harmful.
Those opposed to the movie cited the violence expected to be associated with the horror flick as a reason for banning the film crew from campus.
The thing that needs to be understood, though, is the decision to not allow the Wes Craven production here was not based on people's views of morality or the content of the film. It was based on the disruption of the educational program.
And then they got it. They got this out.
And left us there. I can understand the trauma that was on that area because of that case, but they were very harsh. We were treated like scum.
I don't draw any judgment upon his work. I think he's a talented and brilliant guy. It's just a game we didn't want to play, and we weren't interested in pursuing it.
I did put in the entrance, and no thanks whatsoever to the center. Froze the school board.
I guess he got his last word in on us, and maybe appropriately so.
Craven and his crew ultimately solved their location issue when they were invited to shoot the film's high school sequences at a local community center in the neighboring town of Sonoma.
It had been a high school, and it didn't fall to the jurisdiction of any of the school boards, so we could pay to use it, and that ended up being the high school.
And we put the big sign, Woodsboro sign, up over the thing, and put some lockers in the hallway.
Oh yeah, Woodsboro doesn't exist.
Was to be the home of it just... and Dewey Riley,
say,
which turned out
say.
To be near two other that had already earned
Santa Rosa
film pedigree.
Across the street from Tatum's house, Rose McGowan's house, was the Pollyanna house. And then next door, across the side street, is the house that was used in Alfred Hitchcock's Shadow of a Doubt.
With its filming locations finally secured, production of Wes Craven's scary movie officially began on April 15th, 1996.
Action! The first 5 days of photography in Scream was the opening Drew Barrymore sequence.
That character Casey was, you were so with her, making her tippy pop and home alone.
She's vulnerable. She thinks she's safe because she's in her home.
That whole opening with Drew was meant to start in a completely innocent way and get heavier and heavier and heavier. And I love the elements that sort of tied it to, you know, when a stranger calls, that creepy guy on the phone.
Why haven't you checked the children?
It's something of a cultural icon. All you have to say is,
we traced a call. It's coming from inside the house.
And everyone would know what you were talking about.
But the idea... Jeez, Roger Jackson, seriously, is the creepiest guy ever.
And that they're wandering around your house looking at you is terrifying. Like the frightening film that inspired it. The terror threatening the young girl just a phone call away. And voice actor Roger Jackson's job was to provide the menace that would make Drew Barrymore's performance seem very, very real.
It's my job to try and scare the hell out of you.
A lot of what she did, that full tilt, screaming, running around on her bare feet, that was all for real. She found it. She brought it.
I mean, people thought, well, Drew Barrymore is going to be in the whole film, and it suddenly was this, almost a psycho switch, where he just dispenses over so quickly.
I cried when, you know, Drew Barrymore gets stabbed. I thought her performance was magnificent.
It was so powerful. She did such an amazing job with it. That's great. I'm working with it. It turned out to be one of the
unreal,
so to speak.
But despite Wes Craven's confidence, he still had to prove his vision of the film to the studio.
I know as those dealers were coming in, there was concern on part of the studio that it wasn't going to be scary, that it wasn't being shot the way they had hoped it would be being shot. I know they were putting all sorts of pressure on Wes and everything like that.
And in Hollywood parlance, that means you're about to be fired.
There was a lot of things in the beginning that were, that could have made the ship sink.
Bob hated the ghost film. It was shot the entire Drew Barrymore scene with it.
The audiences would be scared about it, but it shows you what I know.
It's difficult, you know, because you have a lot of cooks in the kitchen.
So the filmmakers set out to prove to the studio the opening sequence and the look of the film's ghost-faced killer would indeed work.
We immediately cut it as fast as we could.
They had two different versions of the mask. One was the K&B version, which was used in the first scene with Drew Barrymore. And the other one was the ghost face mask that you see right in today.
Having a strong vision, and he really put himself out there. With the first scenes complete, Wes Craven led his cast and crew onward, but nothing could prepare them for what would end up being the longest, most grueling, and bloodiest night in horror movie history. In the spring of 1996, production on Scary Movie was moving forward. Despite a bitter fight with the local school board over permission to film in the local high school. In addition, actress Drew Barrymore had opted out of playing the lead role, choosing instead to portray the slasher film's first on-screen victim. While these hurdles were behind them, director Wes Craven and his team faced yet another challenge, shooting the film's climactic and blood-drenched 42-minute finale.
Yeah, that was the scene from hell. It was essentially the whole third act. So it began with the party at the house, at Stu's house, and since it didn't change locations, it all was lumped under.
And that house where Stu was is actually
that just became kind of a
used for a tour now.
I've seen 118.
It's how people live, people die.
It just kind of seemed endless that we were up at this house, and just night after night, that was where, you know, Billy and Sid made love. That was where Randy gave his rules of horror. That was where Dewey and Gale showed up, and it just went on and on and on. We were at that location forever.
Shot over a grueling 21-night schedule, the film's last act would see the end of many of its most memorable characters, beginning with Sidney's loyal best friend, Tatum. It was wet every night, cold, wet, and Rose McGowan, she was cold.
And to this day, I get asked if I had some sort of a prosthetic in my chest, which I didn't even know was possible. I had no idea what was going on, but it became very popular with boys.
Her breasts were very, very taut.
It was cold there when we were shooting. I mean, it was very nipply.
I know, good.
Oh, brother. You guys are weird.
Such as her character's impending death scene.
And it's really fun killing Rosemary, but the only problem is she says she couldn't scream. So that's a lot of work. She was getting killed in the garage door.
They actually had to nail me to the inside of the garage door so I wouldn't fall through. I had bruises from hanging and, like, screaming and going up and down and up and down. I did find that I can, in fact, fit through doggy doors.
She got through. It was amazing. She got much farther through than I thought she would.
Also amazing, at least to the actors in hindsight, was the fact that no one, including Tatum's own brother, Deputy Dewey, seemed to acknowledge poor Tatum's untimely demise.
I feel quite badly that Dewey was never sad about Tatum's death.
I mean, I obviously should have mourned the death of my sister.
What a cold.
That happened later in the hospital room.
What do you mean? She's gone.
The next to find himself at the mercy of Ghostface was Ken.
Alright guys, I'm gonna end the video here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys like this video, give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, turn post notifications, and leave a comment. Subscribe to your channel so my site thing. And yeah, guys, again, I'm almost close to 500 subscribers. 500 subscribers, that's a lot. If I reach a goal, I really appreciate it. But yeah, this is very much close to my goal. I reach 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 people watching. So for your goal, I really appreciate it. Peace again. Thanks for being able to pass to you guys. And I love you guys so much for all your support. Like I always say, and I always mean. And yeah. Also, if you guys want to watch this, it was made by Sam Fly. Again, I'll put the link to his video down in the description. We're almost close to the end of this, guys. Almost close. But yeah. Alright guys, there you go. Thanks so much for watching. Please like this video, leave a big comment, subscribe for more, and I'll catch you guys for tomorrow for part 7 of my reaction to Scream the Inside Story. Alright guys, there you go. Goodbye, and have a good day or night.